Today we will write a program to check for prime number using control statements. Okay, the objective of this program is to input a number and to check prime or not. Okay, prime or not, this is the objective of the program. Okay, now we need to input a number for this, correct? Now first we need to input a number. Okay, take variable as number equal to input. This is a input function to input a number, and input message enter a number. Okay, once you input a number, you know that whatever you input, it is takes as string by default. Therefore, you have to convert inputted number into integer, int of number, by using int function. Okay, number is now converted into integer. Now, here to check whether it is prime or not, we need to make use of a flag variable and initialize it to 1. Make use of flag variable and initialize it to 1. I will tell why to make use of flag variable when I iterate through loop. Okay, now you generate divisor for inputted number. What is a prime number? Prime number is nothing but number which is divisible by 1 and itself and not divisible by any other number. Okay, this is a logic we have to write now. Okay, why we have to generate a divisor? Because we need to generate a divisor in such a way that for d is a divisor variable, in such a way that divisor should start from 2. Okay, divisor should start from 2 for d in a range. Okay, from 2 up to number minus 1, correct? Now, but here in the for loop, now if you give just number, it generates a divisor up to number minus 1. Okay, this is a one way of iteration. There are three ways of iterations to check for the prime number. Three ways of generating the divisor. Okay, this is a one way. Okay, I will tell that two more ways after this program, after this type of generation of division. Okay, for d in the range 2 to number, you have to make a block of statement. Therefore, inside the for loop, you have to write block of statement. Give colon here. You have to check if number percentage d for modulus division equal to 0. If remainder equal to 0, put colon here. One more indentation, you see flag I initialize to 0. Okay, I assign a 0 to flag. If remainder is 0, flag is 0. Okay, see, once you make flag equal to 0, no need of more iteration, no need to generate one more divider, or no need to do one more division operation. You have to come out of for loop, because once the modulus division gives remainder 0, it means that number is not prime number. No need to do some more division. Just come out of the loop by using the break statement. Okay, now you are coming out of loop after by using break statement. Outside the loop, you have to check if flag equal to 1. Okay, if a flag remains 1 during division operation, if flag remains 1, it is meant that the inputted number is prime number. Inputted number is prime number. Okay. Otherwise, the inputted number is not prime number. Put colon. Else has to be. See, colon has to be put here. Okay, colon has to be put here. If flag equal to 1, number is prime. Else, after else you have to put colon. Print number is not prime. Else print number is not prime. Okay, flag equal to 1, number is prime. Else number is not prime. Okay, now you run the program. See, it is asking enter a number, input a number, input number 9 and press enter. It is not prime. 9 is not prime, correct na? 9 is not prime. Input one more number, run input 51 is not prime. Run 53 is a prime number, correct? See, thus whatever number you inputted, if it is a prime, it prints as prime. 78 is not prime. Once again run, give any number, 87, run, it is 87 plus enter, it is not prime. Okay, like that, run and enter the number 89, enter, 89 is prime number. Thus you can check whether it is prime or not. This is one way of generating the divisor. If you want to reduce number of iteration, here instead of telling divisor from 2 to number minus 1, you can tell the divisor from 2 to number by 2. Okay, number by 2 and it's a integer equivalent. Integer equivalent. Okay, because range upper limit should be integer. Okay, see here, number by 2. Or you can make a integer. Instead of using integer function, you can return integer equivalent after the division by 2 slashes, correct? This way also you can do number 2 division, 2 slashes for integer division, and it has to generate the divisor from 2 to number by 2. Okay, here also if you want to perfectly generate the divisor from 2 to number by 2, you have to add 1 and make use of bracket. Okay, it generates the divisor from 2 to number by 2 plus 1. Now it reduces the number of iteration, but output is same. Run. Okay, enter the number 89, enter, 89 is prime number. Okay, run, enter the number 87, 87 is not prime. Still you can reduce the number of iteration by making the divisor square root of given number. Okay, making the divisor square root of given number, but to use square root function, you have to make use of math.sqrt function, math models sqrt function. Okay, square root of number, square root of number. Okay, math.square root of number, and you know that square root of number generates a square root of given number, but here range function will generate 1 less than given square root, therefore add 1 to that. And you already know that square root generates fractional number, fractional part, therefore make use of int function to convert it into integer and add 1. Okay, add 1. Now you run. Okay, see the brackets, 1 2 3 brackets open, 1 2 3 brackets closed. Now you run. Okay, see, invalid syntax, line 5 in math.strt. Okay, see here. What it is invalid syntax? You have to import math model, okay, to make use of math.strt function. Brackets numbers are same. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 brackets opened. 1, 2, 3, one more bracket need to be closed. Okay, therefore it is giving syntax error. Okay, now you see run, enter 89, enter, it is prime number. Okay, this way you can reduce the number of iteration. Once again you run, 87 is not a prime number. Okay, see here, math.strt generates the square root of given number and convert it to integer, because upper limit should be integer, and add 1 to that. Okay, this way you can generate less number of division operation and less number of iteration in checking the prime number. Now we see how to generate prime number, okay, in between given upper limit. This is to generate prime number. Okay, generate prime numbers. Here you have to input upper limit, okay, prime number till some upper limit or till n value. Okay, n equal to input, enter message, enter upper limit. Now once you enter n as upper limit, you know n contains a string equivalent of entered number, therefore you have to convert it into integer, int of n, stored in the variable n. Now if you want to generate natural number between 1 to n, you know that 1 and 2 are known as prime number. You can generate prime number here from 3. Okay, take a variable number in range of 3 to upper limit you entered, no, that is in n, correct? You make it as n plus 1 because it generates till n minus 1. You make it as n plus 1. Give colon, enter. Now inside this loop you have to check whether this number that is generated is prime or not. If it is prime, you have to print that number. For that purpose, you know that we have to make use of flag variable and initialize flag to 1. Now we have to generate divisor for each number. Divisor with the variable d, d in range, okay, d in range. Divisor always starts from 2 for the given number till sqrt, math dot sqrt of generated number. You know that math dot sqrt gives a fractional part also, therefore convert it into integer. Okay, and after converting to integer, add 1, because you know it is the problem of range, it gives 1 less than that generated square root, you have to add 1. Okay, now you check the brackets, 1, 2, 3, there are 3 brackets here also, 1, 2, 3 brackets. This is for divisor iteration, for dividing operation, d having divisor. You have to check for remainder during the division. If number percentage d for modulus division equal to 0 indicates remainder is 0, indicates what? That number is divisible by some number in the divisor. Then it is not a prime number, therefore make a flag equal to 0 and just come out of the loop. Why you have to give break statement? Break statement to come out of the loop, because during division if remainder is 0, then number is not prime number because it is divisible by some division. It is not prime. Make flag equal to 0, then break indicates no need of more number of division operation. Just come out of inner for loop and stop division operation. After stopping division operation, you have to check outside the inner for loop. That is inside the outer for loop by using flag variable. If flag is 0, this flag is 0, you no need to print that number. If flag is 1, then only print number because it is prime. Print number. Okay, because it is prime. That's all. Flag 1, then only print the number. Now you are inside the outer for loop. Okay. It checks for flag for the generated number. Okay, if it is prime number, it prints. Otherwise, okay, it generates one more number and divisor for that number it generates from 2 to square root of that number, and already initialize flag to 1 and checks if remainder is 0, makes flag equal to 0. If remainder is not 0, then this both statement will not work. If remainder is not 0, after all iteration of division operation, if remainder is not 0, then flag remains 1, indicates that number is prime and you have printed the number. Okay, this is a simple program for generating the prime number between given upper limit. Okay, you know that 1 and 2 both are prime number, therefore outside the for loop you can print 1 and print 2. Afterwards you can generate number from 3 to n plus 1. Okay, one is simple logic. Now you run, it is asking enter upper limit. Enter upper limit as 10, press enter. Yes, it is showing some error. Showing some error, math is not defined. Because, see, till this statement this works properly, but when it goes to math.sqrt, it is giving math is not defined because, yes, it's correct, error is correct, because we are not imported math model. You give import math. Okay, import math imports a mathematics or math model. For sqrt function, math model is important, then only you can use math.sqrt function. Okay, now you run, enter upper limit, give 10, enter. 12357 is the prime number. Once again run the program, give upper limit as 100. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 19, 20, 23, 97. Properly it's generating the prime number between 1 to given upper limit with the less number of iteration, because division is starting from 2 to square root of that number. Okay.